What's up, everybody? CHM Carnivores here. I hope you're having a wonderful day and a wonderful week. Now, today I want to try something a little bit different. I want to talk about a growing school of thought that I am seeing out there on the forums, on the how-to pages, in articles on ICPS, of all things, talking about whether or not carnivorous plants need dormancy, specifically Venus flytraps. Now, I want to talk about that, talk about what the traditional school of thought is and what this new school of thought is, and is there any validity to that? And so this is going to be about me breaking down both sides and leaving it open for you to make your own conclusions. I also talk about what I feel is the correct approach. All that and more coming your way in just a minute. See you soon. There are a lot of different carnivorous plants that do require winter dormancy. At least that has been the pervasive thought for several years, and for good reason. Now, there is a new pervasive thought that is taking over, specifically around Venus flytraps, and if they, in fact, need a winter dormancy. Now, Venus flytraps have been around for about 75 million years, and they grow in a 75-mile radius between South Carolina and North Carolina on the border there, but they also have been planted in North Florida, where it is, they're not innate to that area, but they are growing there and they've been fine. There's also another location in Jamaica where they are growing, and so this has sparked a lot of controversy around the whole winter dormancy. So why am I telling you this information before we get into the nitty-gritty? Well, for one is the fact that they've been around and evolving for so long means it is very difficult to get around the idea of how we can usurp that sort of natural process that's occurred for so long. And why do they need dormancy in the first place? And is that a need or is that a must? And by most, those both sound pretty much the same. But what I mean by that is it a must in order for survival, or they need to go into dormancy in order to survive? While those things seem like I'm saying the exact same thing, what I'm trying to get at is, if they don't go dormant, will they die? Or do they only go dormant because the weather drops or the photoperiod drops, and that would cause them to die if they did not go dormant, i.e., if those things were taken out of the equation, would they need that dormancy in order to survive long term? So why do they go dormant in the first place, and why is that important for the long-term health of the plant? Well, they go dormant because the photoperiod slowly starts to decline as you get further into the year, and so they don't get nearly as much sun, so they don't get as much energy. And of course, if it gets really cold, 50 degrees or less, they need to go dormant in order to be able to protect themselves from dying off because of frost. And so because of this reduced amount of light and the amount of energy that would be required for them to survive through the winter, they go dormant, they go down and store all their energy into their rhizomes, and this helps them long-term protect themselves and keep from dying off because of the cold and the lack of energy. Now let's say, for instance, now that these are taking off in private cultivation, what if we remove those barriers? What if we take away the idea of a photo period by providing grow lights? And what if we take away the cold temperatures by providing a temperate environment where it doesn't get below 50 degrees? And this is the new mainstream argument. Now, if you grow Venus flytraps outside, none of this matters because for the most part, unless you live in a very tropical location, it's going to take care of itself and nature is going to do its thing. But for a lot of new grower, or for a lot of growers rather, they are growing their plants in controlled environments like this, and they are saying that they are able to go years without putting their Venus flytrap in dormancy and are seeing success. And what I want to do is I want to pick that argument apart, and let's talk about the pros and cons, why that might be the case short term, or if it's a long term fix, and what my thoughts are on it. When it comes to the controlled environments, should you usurp the plant's natural ability to go through those cycles? Should you willingly, or knowingly rather, put that plant in a situation where it won't go into dormancy, and what can you expect as a result? Now, I do grow Venus flytraps. Admittedly, it's not the largest part of my collection, but I will tell you that I have had plants that have not gone into dormancy, and while they are surviving, they certainly are not thriving. Now, I know this is not always the case, and there's a lot of factors involved when growing these plants and making sure that they are taken care of. First and foremost, these plants were bought at a big box store in those death cubes, so they already were not the strongest of plants. They're also tissue culture plants, which they're not going to be nearly as strong as well as like a seed grown plant. So that does have it working against it. However, while the plant may survive maybe 1, even 2 years without dormancy, the school of thought and what I've seen personally, as the plant will continue to slow down, and over time, the thought is that plant will eventually run out of energy, tire itself out, and die. Now, there is a difference in different types of dormancies. What I am starting to see and what I'm starting to read about is in places that are a little bit more temperate and don't get nearly as cold, it's almost as if the plant goes into a half dormancy, where somewhere it's very cold, it will die all the way down and then will come back up when things are more in line with what they need to grow. But in Florida here, what I'm seeing is the plant will almost go down to this half dormancy. We'll still keep some leaves that are very, very low hugging to the ground, but they have traps, but those traps are extremely sluggish and are basically useless. They might catch prey if the prey happens to crawl in there and be really slow, but for the most part, those leaves are probably there for just the little bit amount of photosynthesis that they might get from the smaller photo period, and it might not just be hard enough of a cold for them to go into full dormancy. So my plants have gone without dormancy and have done okay. But here's the problem that I think a lot of growers are getting into, and they say, well, hey, my plants haven't gone into dormancy and they are thriving. They're bushing out more and more. What you need to understand is the nature of a Venus flytrap, and that is that they grow these offshoots via rhizomes. And so what you might be seeing is rhizome offshoots and not necessarily the plant itself that you bought that could be in fact dying out or tiring out at least. To further complicate the issue, Venus flytraps were introduced to Jamaica several decades ago, and there is a population there that has thrived. Now, obviously Jamaica is not getting nearly as cold, and so that has been the main driver for a lot of these people saying, hey, if they're gonna thrive in Jamaica, they're not gonna need a dormancy. However, they are grown at a higher elevation in that national park in Jamaica, where it doesn't necessarily get hard freeze by any means, but it will get cold enough to put them in sort of that quasi dormancy. And so that's important for people to understand when they're reading these forums, is while this plant might not go into a hard dormancy, they're still having that rest period, and that is important. So as I was reading that article and I was reading people's justifications for it, it was reminding me of like, wait a minute, I don't think we're seeing the whole picture in the context that it is. And it isn't that the plant has somehow decided to about face and no longer needs this, but it is that it is going through enough to be able to sustain that population and get the rest that it needs. Now, I have not personally seen a lot of these plants other than in pictures, and so who knows what the state of those plants are. It could be that those plants are barely hanging on, or it could be that they're thriving, and that would go a long ways in determining whether or not this sort of quasi-dormancy is actually a viable long-term benefit. Now, it has been a decade, so it is enough to keep them going, but is it enough to make them thrive for centuries to come? At the beginning of this video, in the intro, I talked about, is this a Venus flytrap, does it need dormancies for survival, or does it have to go into dormancy for survival? And I think both of those questions need to be answered, but I think at the end of the day, it may not matter. So what I mean by that is it has to go into dormancy to survive because it can't stand the cold weather and it can't stand the shorter photo period. So it's just doing what it has to do for survival. And if given another opportunity, it wouldn't do that. Now we see a little bit of that in its behavior when it goes into these sort of quasi dormancies. But I don't know that that's necessarily an ideal situation more than it is just it hasn't triggered those elements in the plant's evolution to send it into a full dormancy. And I personally have not yet seen the long-term effects in other people's collections of what that will do to the plant itself long-term, and whether that lack of rest, if you will impact the plant overall. So does it need to go into dormancy will be the real question to answer as this school of thought continues to grow. Over the short period of time, these plants will survive and can skip a couple years of dormancy. Some say one, some say two, and will survive. It will continue to grow offshoots on their rhizomes, but that doesn't necessarily mean the plant is healthy. It could mean that the plant is doing whatever it can to just try to survive while the main plant loses its energy. And that brings up other questions of, if it's utilizing its energy to develop offshoots, is that further depleting the plant's overall energy and shortening its life cycle? The purpose of this video is to start up conversations, because this is a very, very important topic. Venus flytraps in cultivation are starting to take off. And so it's important that we pay attention to what the plant needs and not what we want to give the plant. Everybody wants to have a plant that's beautiful and vibrant throughout the year so they can enjoy it all the time. But we need to pay very close attention to what the plant needs for survival. And that is the question that I propose here is, do we think that the plant doesn't need this, or do we think the plant simply had to do it in the wild? And now that it's grown in a climate controlled environment, we can look past that. So I'm interested to hear what you all have had in your experience, if you've skipped any dormancies, and what that has looked like for you and what you think that will look like for the long term. Now, this happens to be a very, very contentious topic right now in the carnivorous plant community, which is interesting because I did not understand the full magnitude of how much this argument is circulating right now. And there are people online who are saying, absolutely not, these plants do not need a dormancy. And there are other people who say, absolutely, this plant does need a dormancy. There are people who are all the way on the left, and there are people all the way on the right. And then there are people in the middle who say, hey, they don't need dormancy, but they're not going to grow as big and beautiful for you in the long term. And there are people who say, they do need dormancy, and they will grow for you for a little bit, but then will die. Now, it's important to remember that the Venus flytraps can last for a very, very long time. And so they can be in your collection for a while if grown appropriately. And so my concern is, with this growing arena of people talking about them not needing dormancy, is they're not understanding the long-term impact of that. And if they grow them in the short term and then all of a sudden they start having mass die-offs, what does that look like for the future of collecting Venus flytraps? And then how does this ongoing issue sort of bleed over into other plants like Drosera, Bonata, Filiformis that need dormancy as well? Now, there are some Bonata that are already growing without dormancy, and there are some Filiformis that have sort of a quasi-dormancy as well, like a Florida Red. And so the question is, where does this conversation end, and how is that going to change the overall landscape as we continue to develop this school of thought, and it pervasively squeezes in to the overall community? So why make this video? You see, it's not just run-of-the-day growers like myself who are talking about this. These are big-name growers. These are big-name suppliers who are postulating the idea that these plants don't need dormancy. And so the question is that I propose to you is it in fact factually true, or is that what we want to believe, that these plants don't need dormancy? And so there's a lot of research yet to be done. My concern is that for new growers seeing this sort of information, I'm going to go ahead and call it misguided information, not misinformation, but misguided, because I can't yet conclude myself whether or not it in fact is needed. Now, in my professional and personal opinion, again, with the evolution of these plants being so long, my thought is we're not going to be able to turn that around, certainly not in several lifetimes. But again, it will remain to be seen. Now, I am planning on getting several more Venus flytraps here in the future. And so what I might end up doing is having a controlled test to see if one can grow against another and see what that looks like. But that's still going to be a very small window into a much larger idea of what this looks like long term. So these are the kind of conversations that we need to be able to have respectfully and come to a definitive conclusion. Now, for a lot of growers, growing Venus flytraps and any other carnivorous plants is just a hobby. That's just what they're doing for fun. The problem is that if what ends up happening as time progresses is a school of thought, if given enough backing, will take over. And this causes a lot of misguided new growers to feel that they can grow a plant a certain way. And then when it dies, they get very disappointed, become sort of no longer wanting to grow them. And so that's where the problem occurs, and that's where it becomes impactful to the overall survival of these plants. Now, my personal feeling on it is they do in fact need dormancy. And I can respect that there are other people who don't feel that way. And what I would like to do with this video, and hopefully you've been here with me this long, is let's respectfully talk through what our feelings are and what data do we have to back this up, including as these plants continue to be introduced to the wild, which I have my feelings about that as well, in places that aren't native to them and more of a tropical location, and we continue to see ongoing long-term growth for that. What does that mean for the landscape of the Venus flytrap and other carnivorous plants that potentially need dormancy? Are we going to find out that that is a survival mechanism, or are we going to find out that that is a necessity for survival? So these are a lot of questions that we have to postulate, we have to think on, but I would contend that we need to have those conversations now before we are being reactive. I hope you've enjoyed this video, and I hope that it spurred some thoughts and some feelings, and I can't wait to see what your feedback is on it and how you feel about it. I hope you have a wonderful day and a wonderful week. See you soon.